गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम प्रैक्टिस सेट 3.1। इन टुडेज वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द सेकेंड एंड थर्ड क्वेश्चन। सेकेंड क्वेश्चन इज राइट एन अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन हुज फर्स्ट टर्म इज ए एंड कॉमन डिफरेंस इज डी इज गिवेन, देन वी हैव टू राइट द अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन। हियर आई टेक फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल। Now what is the first example? A is equal to 10, that is the first term of the arithmetic progression, and its common difference D is equal to 5, that is given. From that we have to form the arithmetic progression. In solution, here we write A, first term, which is represented as T1 is equal to 10. Second term of the arithmetic progression. To find out the second term of the arithmetic progression, you have to add the common difference in previous term. Therefore, second term is T2 is equal to first term, that is T1 plus common difference D is equal to 10 plus 5. 10 is the first term and common difference is 5 that we have to add is equal to 15. In this way, here we get the second term of the arithmetic progression. Similarly, we find out the third term. Then third term is equal to, we have to add the common difference in second term. Therefore, T3 is equal to T2 plus D is equal to, now second term of the arithmetic progression here we find, that is 15 plus common difference 5 is equal to 20. Then similarly find out the fourth term. T4 is given by T3 plus D is equal to third term of the arithmetic progression, that is 20 plus common difference 5 is equal to 25. In this way here we get first term, second term, third term and the fourth term of the arithmetic progression. Therefore, required arithmetic progression is 10, 15, 20, 25 and so on. Okay, student, I hope you understand how to do this question. Now, we see the next example, third example. In that, first term is given A is equal to minus 7, D is equal to 1 upon 2. 1 upon 2 we can write in decimal form 0.5. Similarly, then in solution, here we write A first term is equal to minus 7. Then second term is given by T1 plus D is equal to value of first term is minus 7 plus common difference is 0.5. Minus 7 plus 0.5, here we get answer minus 6.5. That is the second term of the arithmetic progression. Then what is the third term? Third term is represented as T3 is equal to second term plus common difference, that is T2 plus D is equal to second term is minus 6.5 plus, here we have to add the common difference 0.5 is equal to, their subtraction is minus 6. Similarly, we find out the fourth term, that is T3 plus D is equal to third term is minus 6 plus common difference 0.5, their subtraction is minus 5.5. In this way, here we get first term, second term, third term and the fourth term of the arithmetic progression. Therefore, we write the answer. Required arithmetic progression is minus 7, minus 6.5, minus 6 and minus 5.5 and so on. Okay. In this way, here we get the arithmetic progression when the first term and the common difference is given. Okay. Now, we see fifth example from same question number. Again here first term is given A is equal to 6, common difference D is equal to minus 3. Okay, we have to find out the arithmetic progression. Same method we have to use. First we write the first term, A is equal to T1 is equal to 6. To find out the second term of the arithmetic progression, then T2 is equal to first term plus common difference. First term is what? T1 plus D is equal to 6 plus, what is common difference now? This is negative, therefore minus 3 is equal to 6 plus minus, that is minus 3 is equal to 3, here we get. Similarly, we find out the third term. Third term is given by T3 is equal to T2 plus D. Second term here we find, that is 3 plus common difference is minus 3. 3 plus minus, that is minus 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. Now next term T4 is equal to T3 plus D is equal to third term here we find out 0 plus minus 3 plus minus, that is minus 0 minus 3 is equal to what? Minus 3. Therefore, our required arithmetic progression is for the value of a is equal to c and common difference minus 3 is 6, 3, 0, minus 3 and so on. Now, in this question, we observe that when the common difference is negative, then here we get the arithmetic progression in descending order. If you see the first example and the second example, here common difference is positive, then arithmetic progression in ascending order. Remember this, okay? Now, we see the third question. Now, what is the third question given here? Question is given, find the first term and common difference for each of the arithmetic progression. Now, in this question, arithmetic progression is given. From that arithmetic progression, we have to find out the first term and the common difference. Here we see the first example from question number 3. Arithmetic progression is given 5, 1, minus 3, minus 7 and so on. Okay, first here we write the first term of the arithmetic progression. It is represented as A or T1. Therefore, A is equal to T1 is equal to what? 5. Then second term of the arithmetic progression, T2 is equal to what? 1. T3 is equal to what? Minus 3 and T4 is equal to minus 7. In this way here we get first term, second term, third term and the fourth term of the arithmetic progression. Now from this arithmetic progression we have to find out the common difference. Therefore D is equal to, D is common difference is the difference between two consecutive terms, isn't it? Therefore D is equal to second term minus first term. Therefore we write here T2 minus T1. What is the second term here? That is 1. First term is minus 5. Sorry, first term is 5. Therefore, 1 minus 5. Here we get minus 4. Okay. Similarly, we find out the common difference or difference between the next two consecutive terms. That is T3 minus T2 is equal to third term is minus 3. Second term is 1. Therefore, minus 3 minus 1. Again, here we get minus 4. Similarly, we find out the difference between the fourth term and the third term. Therefore, T4 minus T3 is equal to fourth term is minus 7 minus third term is minus 3. Therefore, minus 7 minus minus 3 is equal to minus 7 as it is, minus minus become plus 3 is equal to minus 7 plus 3 is equal to minus 4. In all this, the difference between consecutive term, that is constant, and this is the common difference for the arithmetic progression. Therefore, our answer is first term of the arithmetic progression, that is 5, it is represented as A is equal to 5, and common difference for this arithmetic progression D is equal to what? Minus 4. Students, I hope you understand how to find out the first term and the common difference of the arithmetic progression. We see one more example. Here I take the question number 4. In question number 4, arithmetic progression and numbers are given in the fraction form. Okay, don't worry about this. Now what is the arithmetic progression is given? That is 1 upon 4. Second term is given 3 upon 4, 5 upon 4, 7 upon 4 and like that. This is the given arithmetic progression. From this arithmetic progression, we write represent their terms. Therefore, A is equal to what? T1, first term, is equal to 1 upon 4. Second term, that is 3 upon 4. Third term, that is 5 upon 4. And fourth term, that is 7 upon 4. Here we represent the terms of the arithmetic progression. Then we find out the common difference. Now, what is common difference is given by? That is the D is equal to difference between two consecutive terms. And it is given by second term minus first term. Therefore, we write T2 minus T1 is equal to 3 upon 4 minus first term is 1 upon 4. Now, denominator is same. Here we write as it is. In numerator, 3 minus 1. 3 minus 1. That is 2 upon 4 and its simplest form is 1 upon 2. Similarly, we find out the D is equal to the difference between next two consecutive term, that is third term and the second term, that is T3 minus T2. Third term is 5 upon 4 minus second term is 3 upon 4 is equal to common denominator 4 as it is, numerator 5 minus 3 is 5 minus 3. is equal to 2 upon 4, here we get 1 upon 2. And then next, D is equal to T4 minus T3 is equal to 4 term is 7 upon 4 minus 3rd term is 5 upon 4 is equal to common denominator 4 as it is. In numerator, 7 minus 5 is equal to 2 upon 4, that is 1 upon 2. From this arithmetic progression, here we get the first term A is equal to 1 upon 4 and the common difference D is equal to 1 upon 2. Students, I hope you understand the question number 3rd also. Now, what is the homework for you? From second question, question number 2nd, example number 2nd, 4 and 6, this is the homework. And from question number 3rd, 1st and 4, this is the homework for you. Thank you. Thank you, student.